So tell me, Shauna, how long have you been running for leukemia research?
I've been running for leukemia research for about 2 years, just over 2 years.
Okay, and how did you get involved?
Through Cal, a friend, and he's been running for leukemia research for about, I don't know, maybe 4 or 5 years. And so I sort of steadily, I got involved by going along just for fun for a race in Forfar. There was a marathon around Forfar town centre in sort of Ardbothy way. And Cal and various other actors, celebrities were running and I was watching and they were doing a relay. And I got involved that day. But I wasn't wearing any of the correct trainers or anything, so I got a bit listless. But since then I've done sort of longer races and trained rather than just sort of turning up.
So has it raised much money then?
Well, last year we raised £1 million and all the money goes towards research and none of the money goes to anything like, you know, monuments or sculptures or sort of useless visual things and sort of in memory of anybody. It doesn't work like that. All the money goes straight to research or medical resources or hospitals.
So can you tell me what made you start running in the first place?
Well, I like keeping fit, but running is it's great to run for a charity as well because we do about 8 races a year. You feel that you're running for a reason and you've got something to aim for. Like last year I did the New York Marathon in November, so I had something to aim for. This year I'm doing I've already done quite a few 10Ks, but there's a half marathon coming up in Newcastle. There's also a triathlon that I've started to train for. So I train to keep fit, I train to chill out, and I train to keep occupied as well when my work seems to dry up. So, many reasons.
So what was your time in New York?
New York, I was a little disappointed. It was 3 hours and 37 minutes. I wanted 3 hours and 30, but a couple of weeks before, the Descent had been released in Paris and stuff, so there was lots of partying going on. And also, apparently, New York's very difficult. So I did well. Liz McColgan, who sort of does all my, she made up a training schedule for me and she's been in contact, she was in contact with me quite a lot. She said it was still a very, very good time, so that's fine.
Now, you missed the London Marathon.
Yes,
why
I did.
Why is that?
Well, I got shin splints from possibly overtraining, but I don't think it was. It was being foolish and training in trainers that I should have had replaced, so I didn't have enough support. So I had to pull out 2 weeks before the marathon, so I was a bit gutted about that because I was, like 3 weeks before I pulled out, or maybe it was 2 weeks, I did the Edinburgh half marathon in an hour and 30 minutes, which is good. So, but they'll be next year. I'm hoping actually to do New York as well in November, but we'll see.
That's a goal for the future.
Yes. After I get this triathlon out of the way, and that's going to be in Salford on the 30th of July, so I've got about 7 weeks left to train for that, and then I can have a month off, and then I can start training again. Sounds a bit mental. Train again for New York. But if I get a job, which I do have, I mean, if my work schedule is up and up and up, I'll still do the marathon, but I won't be going for a time.
Liz McColgan gave you advice. But do you have any advice for aspiring runners?
Yes. Aspiring, just if they're aspiring in the sort of, well, I won't I, then just run, because it's brilliant. And after you've run 4 times, you'll stop that horrible sick feeling that a lot of people get. But sort of practical advice would be, make sure you have the right trainers. If you go into a proper running shop, they can advise you. If you're flat-footed or whatever, that you need the right support, because everything, all the injuries you get is from the foot. So that's why I got my shin splint problems. A lot of people get knee problems, but that's because you're not wearing the right trainers. So sort out your trainers. If you're a girl, get a sports bra, because that's a nightmare. but make sure you're hydrated, don't eat much before you go and run, because that's why you feel sick and that's why you get a stitch. But if it's just for sort of people who are wanting to start to do fun running, you just have to get out and do it. And it's really nice and sunny, it's summer now, so you don't really have an excuse.
And what about any aspiring actors?
God, same thing, just get out and do it, I think. And if you really want to be an actor, you will be an actor. Because you get so much rejection. The best actors get rejection, and bad actors get rejection as well. But it's the ones that stick to it that make it. And your career is so long, it spans your whole life, because hardly any actors retire. But you've got to be ready for the pitfalls and the high stuff and sort of the ups and downs of it. And you've got to be really strong about it, and you've got to have a sense of humour. Obviously. But yeah, train if you want. You don't have to train as well. But I went to the Royal Scottish Academy of Music and Drama, and I really enjoyed my time there. Some people didn't, but I did.
Well, thank you very much, Shauna.
That's all right. Thanks, Mark.
Hope to see you running again soon.
Thank you.